He was there, He was there. In the end, He'll be there, He'll be there.
What God would have you do tonight, after this session tonight, do you know what God would want you to have if He had complete control over your body? Do you want to know that? Because what if His desire is for you to drive out to the stockyard, you know, right there in Fort Worth, and go to the rodeo and start sharing your faith with everyone? What if God's will, what if God's desire was, you know what, actually tonight, I want you to go to bed after this. In fact, I want you to wake up at 3 in the morning and start talking. Do you really want to know this stuff? Do you really want to know what He would desire to do with your body if He had absolute control of it? And I started asking myself, man, do I want to know this? Because that's a scary thought. See, what Jesus says is, He goes, look, if you're not willing to go out these doors and get nailed to a cross with me, then don't even bother. He goes, because I don't want you to start this Christianity thing, start following me, and then at some point quit because it's too hard. He goes, I want you to calculate the cost. Like a guy building a tower, he doesn't build the foundation, go halfway up and go, oh, I ran out of money. He goes, I don't want you to start following Jesus for a little while and go, oh, I didn't know I'd have to give this up or this up or this up. I didn't know there's a potential of giving up my life. I didn't know there's a potential of selling my house and renting. I didn't know there's a potential, you know, on and on and on. He goes, let me just tell you, unless you're willing to give it all up, forget it. Forget it.
Till it's you alone I live for. It's you alone. Sing that one more time with me. Ruin my life, the plans that I've made, and ruin desires for my own selfish gain. Destroy the idols that have taken your place. Till it's